Coral reefs around the world have had a tough couple of years, and the Great Barrier Reef has certainly not escaped. Our latest round of monitoring covered 124 reefs across the whole Great Barrier Reef, and we've now measured the impacts of the 2024 summer. Our results show that last year's historic high levels of hard coral cover have now declined sharply. Widespread loss of coral is due to record levels of heat stress, leading to mass coral bleaching across the reef in 2024. There were also impacts from cyclones and flood plumes during the same summer, as well as ongoing crown of thorn starfish outbreaks.
Our annual update reports on percentage live coral cover, a well-recognised indicator of coral reef condition. Coral losses have been substantial, with the northern and southern regions the hardest hit. Both regions have had the largest annual decline seen in 39 years of monitoring, with record coral losses on many reefs in both regions. Despite the record losses, the reef still has coral cover near long-term averages in each region. The quick reversal of recent coral recovery appears part of an emerging trend. Previously, coral cover fluctuated in response to disturbances, but over the last 15 years, these fluctuations have become larger, swinging from record lows to record highs. This trend is being driven primarily by more frequent heat stress brought about by climate change.
The northern region lost about a quarter of last year's record coral cover, and this was the biggest drop in a single year that we've ever seen in 39 years of monitoring. This year's surveys confirmed that most of this loss was due to coral bleaching. There was also wave and flood damage from tropical cyclone Jasper between Port Douglas and Cooktown.
In 2024, the southern region experienced record levels of heat stress, leading to the largest annual declines we've ever recorded. Nearly a third was lost. There was also evidence of storm damage, crown of thorn starfish outbreaks, and coral disease. The central region was less affected by the summer's pressure and had smaller declines. This was largely on reefs north of Cairns due to impacts from the coral bleaching and from severe tropical cyclone Jasper. But the rest of the central region remained largely unaffected.
The reefs that lost the most coral this year were those that had the most fast-growing Acropora corals. These corals were responsible for the very fast increases and high coral cover of the last few years. But while they're fast to grow, they're also the first to go. They break easily during storms, they're vulnerable to heat stress, and they're the preferred prey of the crown of thorn starfish.
Widespread coral bleaching was rarely documented before the 1990s. Now we see it regularly. This summer, another mass bleaching event unfolded on the reef. It was the second back-to-back event and the sixth since 2016. While the heat stress in 2025 did not reach the levels of 2024, it did reach levels where we expect some coral mortality. Even when corals aren't killed, they are still stressed, and it could impact their growth and reproduction. Climate change is the greatest threat to the Great Barrier Reef and to coral reefs worldwide. The fourth global coral bleaching event is still underway, and record heat stress in Australia's northwest this year led to unprecedented coral bleaching in this area.
What we need to protect reefs into the future are global efforts to reduce emissions. We also need the continuation of good local management and the development of interventions to help corals adapt and recover. These strategies are crucial to support the animals and the communities that rely on healthy coral reefs.
We'll be back in the water in September to start our 40th year of monitoring the Great Barrier Reef to better understand the changes that are occurring to this beautiful and important ecosystem.